Okay, let's assume that we are in a first stage of our project and we have received this AutoCAD file. Let me open AutoCAD. And we have received a AutoCAD file from our client and we need to scale it in our Revit project. But in some situation and a specific situation, we don't have any idea about the scale of this project. So let me zoom out. And we don't have any idea about the scaling and about the correct scale of this project. So let me select this sheet and let us to cut it and move it to another new project because we are not going to import all of the sheets in this project. We just do a sheet, for example, and you can do the workflow for other sheets too. Let's press Ctrl C. And after that, click here and create a new file. Let us close it. And you can press Ctrl V to paste the file. Right, the origin is not very important here. I just click here and I just save this file on my desktop. Let's call it test1 and save it. Okay, this is the workflow that we need in AutoCAD. We don't have any other work in AutoCAD, so you can close the AutoCAD software and let's go to the Revit. Okay, when you are in Revit project, you need to go to the Insert tab and after that click on Import CAD. And let me choose test one. Here, because we don't have any idea about the scaling and about the dimension, so we don't care about the import unit. But sometimes when you know a scale and also the unit of the received file, you can adjust import unit from here. So I put it on it on auto detect and I don't change it. And also because I just want this file in just level one view, so you should check current view only too. And also let me adjust the positioning on manual because it is going to be too small or too big, and I want to have a full control of the file when I'm placing that. Okay, let us select manual origin and click on open. Okay, let us you can position it everywhere you want. For example, let me put this drawing here, and then the workflow starts from here. Okay, for example, in the first alternative that we know, the dimensions are correct. In the first alternative, you just need to go to the View tab and select your drawing, go to the Modify tab, and then use a Scale tool from here. But before that, summarize a dimension. For example, it is about 278. So summarize it, and after that, click on Scale. Click here, and input the real size now. For example, it was about 278. Okay, now my project has scaled to a real dimensions and to the real measurements. So this is the first alternative. But in some alternative, let me press Ctrl Z twice to return to the smaller file. Okay, but in the second alternative, you don't know that the dimensions are correct or no, and also you don't know anything about the scale. In some situation and a specific situation, you need to work according to the standards. For example, we know that our standard about standard depth is about 30 centimeters. So I just scale our project according to the this dimension or thread depth dimension. Okay, the only work you should do is to select your drawings and go to the modify tab, click on a scale, and click here, and click here, and input 30 centimeter here. Okay. In the second alternative, we scale our project according to the standards and reference. The first one is more accurate, obviously, but sometimes we have no choice. We have no other choice to do. So we should scale our file according to the references and standards.